how do we stop our team from receiving or responding to phishing emails? Well, what's a phishing email? It's just a fake message designed to look legitimate. It costs businesses around the world billions of dollars each year. And these emails will generally impersonate a person or a company that you trust or deal with and attempt to trick you using one of three things. They'll use a fake person, someone pretending to be someone that you know so that you share information or transfer money into the attacker's bank account. They'll set up a fake website so that you share your password or your credit card details or provide a rogue app with permission to access your data. Or they'll attempt to get you to download a fake attachment which installs malware on your device so they can remotely access your computer or encrypt your files. So that's fake people, fake websites, and fake attachments. If we're to give our team the best chance of avoiding phishing emails, we need to configure the features in Microsoft 365 that address these three things, starting with Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection. This is your organization's primary defense against phishing emails. While all Office 365 plans have a built-in anti-phish policy, it doesn't come close to what's offered in Office 365 Advanced Threat Protection, also known as Office 365 ATP. Once you purchase Office 365 ATP, you should jump into the Security and Compliance Center to check out your anti-phishing policy. Its default controls are pretty good for detecting phishing emails that impersonate your users, your domains, and your external contacts. It develops an understanding of how your users and their contacts interact, the addresses that they use, the sending infrastructure that they use, and it looks for anything that's out of the ordinary. If it detects an impersonation attempt, it will either quarantine the message or deliver it with an inline warning. You can enhance your protection by adding users in roles like CEO or CFO, these highly targeted users, to the targeted user protection feature. And you can also add external domains that you frequently interact with to the targeted domains feature. An additional option to detect fake senders is to apply a mail rule that triggers when an external sender sends a message where their display name matches the display name of an internal user. So you can see when people outside the company are trying to impersonate your internal staff. We have an example rule for this on our website that has been pretty popular among smaller organizations. So that helps address fake senders, but what about fake attachments and fake websites? Well, ATP addresses these with the Safe Attachments and Safe Links policy. The Safe Attachments policy can protect your users from malware sent by phishing emails, just like the recent COVID-19 phishing campaign that used an Excel file with macros to install a malicious remote access tool. The Safe Attachments feature analyzes your attachments in a separate sandbox environment, running a bunch of checks for malware, and then it either blocks the email or removes the unsafe attachment. The Safe Links policy, on the other hand, scans your URLs in your emails for links to malicious sites. So this is designed to protect against fake sites that phishers use to harvest your users' credentials. And if a malicious website is detected, then Safe Links blocks users from visiting it. So these tools work by analyzing messages for known malware or bad links or untrusted senders and stopping them from arriving. But what happens if a bad email gets through and the system doesn't realize until later? Well, in that case, we should be using zero-hour auto purge or ZAP. ZAP just removes bad messages from your mailboxes retroactively. Now, I've just discussed four different security policies in a few minutes. And if you've used ATP or Exchange Online Protection, you'll notice there's a lot of security policies to configure and a bunch of them are already set up. So what should you do? Should you leave them as they are or should you make some changes? Well, according to Microsoft, you should make a few changes. Microsoft has two levels of recommended best practices that they say will prevent most unwanted messages from reaching your team's mailboxes. These two levels are called strict and standard. In our experience, strict is very strict. But it's a good starting point that you can enable first and then adjust later on. Once your policies are set up, you should test your users. Teach them how to identify a phishing email and then run an attack simulation against them. With Office 365 ATP, you can run these attack simulations against your team. They help you identify and find vulnerable users before a real attack impacts them. But what happens when messages get through? What happens when users get duped and provide their login details to attackers? We should be protecting our accounts. If a user enters their credentials into a fake website, we need to make sure that an attacker can't use those credentials alone to log in. All Office and Microsoft 365 plans allow us to configure multi-factor authentication. This will ensure that an attacker can't log in without having access to an additional form of verification, such as a phone or an authentication token. And if you have a plan that includes Azure Identity Protection, you should set up your sign-in risk policy to monitor for unusual logins. These policies use machine learning to detect signs of suspicious activity, and then they can either block sign-ins or temporarily block users if something's amiss. Now that accounts are getting more secure by default with multi-factor authentication and security defaults that Microsoft are introducing, attackers are starting to request access to user data via apps. And it's worse if they manage to trick an admin user, because then attackers can have long-standing access to an entire organization that persists even when passwords are changed. It can be challenging to detect if a user clicks a phishing link and then provides a rogue app with access to their mailbox or their OneDrive or their SharePoint data. So we need to use Microsoft Cloud App Security to get alerted to unusual applications with access to our team's information. And finally, take extra care if you or a company that you regularly interact with has been breached before. Because if attackers have access to your data and they know who's who in the company, they know who interacts with who and for what purpose, then they can try to use that information against you. They can set up their fake accounts to start their fake conversations with their fake invoices and get a hold of your real money. So if you need assistance setting up any of these policies, get in touch with us today. We'd be happy to help. We can also help with cleaning up after a successful phishing attack in Microsoft 365. You can get in touch with us today at gcits.com.